Okay, the Headbangers Ball. Gene Simmons is here, obviously. We've been talking about this record for what seems like, I mean, basically since we hooked up a long, long time ago, we were talking about this record, and it finally came out, and everybody's been talking about the Kiss tribute record, and some of the bands that we mentioned that are on it aren't actually on it. Some bands that we didn't have any idea were going to be on it are on it. But right now, I want to talk to you. First of all, how long has this record been in the making?
It actually started a couple of years ago just as an idea that was being tossed around, because we kept noticing all these tribute bands playing all over the world, guys that would put on Kiss makeup and do the shows exactly like.
Because when you saw these, I mean, in L.A. there's some really good ones.
Great.
There's also some really bad ones.
I haven't seen some bad ones.
But there's some great Kiss. Now, when you see bands up there with the makeup on doing the whole Kiss thing, does it feel like these guys are really on, or does it feel like right on?
It's
a little both?
No, it's very flattering. I got to say that when you see a band take that much time and effort to do this stuff, I mean, it really kicks your ass. But I mean, it started to occur to me. I thought, you know, maybe it wouldn't be a bad idea to record one of these bands doing the stuff. And we said, nah, because it's exactly the same versions as we do. And then you only sort of compare the original to the copy. And then we started seeing these bootleg albums come out. One was called Hard to Believe, which was 25 cutting-edge bands doing Kiss songs, Nirvana, Melvins, a lot of other bands. And it was a bootleg. We thought, hey, that's cool. Then there was a Norwegian one that came out called Flaming Youth, 16 Norwegian bands doing Kiss tunes. And then it started to get real, and the title came first, Kiss My Ass. Or is it for our southern neighbors, Kiss My Ass? And then we just let the word out, and we had over 50 artists, Belle Biv DeVoe.
Now, we're going to talk about the artists that are on it and even the artists that aren't on it. But right now we're going to play a song from you guys that was actually done on the record by Toad the Wet Sprocket, which was interesting because that wasn't a band that you would automatically think of as being a huge Kiss fan. But I mean, we're going to talk all about this record and tons of more stuff. Gene Simmons is our guest, and here's Rock and Roll All Night from Kiss. We're back on the Headbangers Ball, hanging with Gene Simmons, and we're going to spend a lot of time talking about this record, also talk about the book. But the one thing that I've mentioned to you before, the times that we've had Kiss on the Headbangers Ball, we get letters just up until the next time you're on the Headbangers Ball. And these letters are not the letters from the kids that are saying, I remember when Kiss Alive came out, how I bought it. These are kids who are just buying Kiss records for the first time. Their parents might have been Kiss fans, and they don't buy the Kiss because it's nostalgic. They buy it because this is what's new. And I was also talking to you a little bit earlier on the computer. I got on this
email.
Yeah, on America Online or something. And there's like just everybody writing just stuff about Kiss.
It's very bizarre. I mean, it's very bizarre because all this activity is going on, certainly without our involvement. There's all these Kiss conventions. There are four of them happening this month around America. There are 32 happening in Europe.
We have. Do you ever go to any of them? Or
I've only been to one. I went to the one in London, and we went to give somebody a gold record as a, you know, sort of a thank you. And it was at the Astoria Theater, just room enough for 1,500 people. You walk in, it was like sardines. You see the steam rising from people. And we're on stage. We couldn't even have a conversation with the guy who was asking us questions because it was all, you're having my baby. Mm-hmm. Paul Anka, you're having my baby. Just one of those days.
I got that one too, though. I did get that.
You did?
I got it.
I mean, it's very bizarre. The fanzines are a thing unto themselves. I mean, the tattoos, they're out of their minds. Look at these people. This is the inside. You'll find this in the packaging. Kiss fans are a little bizarre. They tattoo their bodies.
I mean, and chances are, if you watch the show, you know somebody that's got that or this one of Gene. I mean, there's a lot of people that have.
There's one great story, a very sweet girl who wound up being a very close friend who decided to tattoo. Well, first she shaved, and then she tattooed my face in the most flattering place. My mouth was open.
Use your imagination, ladies and gentlemen. Let's just leave it at
You're
that.
You're having my baby.
We're going to come back with more Gene Simmons, and we'll talk about this record. We're going to talk about each of the people that are on this record, why, and talk about the book when the Headbangers Ball continues. Welcome back on the show. I'm Riki Rachtman. Gene Simmons. I liked the records when they were big like this.
They should really, we've talked about this before, they should really have CD. If you want to have CDs and stuff, okay, stick a small CD in there. Damn it, give us the artwork. Let us look at the lyrics. Let us, you know, see this cool stuff.
We like it big like this.
We do.
Anyways,
size
the
matters.
Record is called Kiss My Ass. It is out in your stores now. I hope you're buying it. It's a Kiss tribute record. Real quick, I want to go through some of the bands on it. Now, I haven't heard the record at all.
Yet. I have.
Okay.
Take it from me. It's very cool.
I have heard that track number one, Deuce from Lenny Kravitz, is awesome.
Let me tell you something.
I've heard that track is awesome. That's what I'm hearing about.
Lenny is a complete crazy guy, as I'm sure you know.
I like Lenny Kravitz.
Artist in his own right, there's no question about it. The guy used to get dressed up in Kiss makeup and go to school to make whatever statement he wanted to make. But obviously there was something inside of him that made him want to get out there and say, I'm not like you, I'm just me. So he went through the entire route and finally did Deuce his way. And I got,
because that's one thing that was important to you. It wasn't, you didn't want to hear them say, wow, this sounds like Kiss. You wanted these bands to show their style doing the songs, right?
That's the whole point of this. I think if every band didn't do
Deuce, it. Deuce is a kind of a funky song, and I could see Lenny really just like
his way. And I mean, it sounds more like Sly and the Family Stone, if anything. It sounds less like Kiss, but that's very important.
Wait, did Stevie Wonder?
Stevie Wonder plays harp on it. Out of this world.
I want to hear that.
And then we got Garth Brooks and his backup band,
see, you know
the Kiss Band.
People might laugh as a... I actually like some Garth Brooks songs.
Hey, look.
And he did Hard Luck Woman. And I heard that he didn't do, like, Hard Luck Woman. I heard he did, like, a rocking version of Hard Luck
Woman. Sounds like young Rod Stewart, the guy Kills. We flew to Nashville. He said, I'll do this song, but without you guys, I'm not going to do it. So we flew to Nashville.
Because Garth was a Kiss fan.
Well, when he was 15, he knows every bizarre lick.
Because Garth Brooks was one of, like, the first country guys. He would go talking about Garth. He used pyrotechnics in his show.
Elevators and...
Which is, like, unheard of in country.
And stuff.
Probably took it from seeing Kiss.
Maybe.
We'll just say that. We got to go to a video right now. Then we're going to come back and talk about the other bands. For instance, the next one, right after Garth Brooks... When would anybody think that right after a Garth Brooks song, you're going to hear an Anthrax song? We're going to tell you what Anthrax does on the Kiss tribute record. But right now, we're going to be playing a song from Anthrax. And you even got on stage and played them a couple times. Talk about that, too.
That's right.
This is Anthrax with Only. Welcome back. We're going through the Kiss My Ass Kiss tribute record, which is out. We talked about Garth Brooks, who I guess is a huge Kiss fan. And we played Anthrax a little bit earlier. Anthrax does the song She, and you've got up on stage a couple times, because Anthrax did do Parasite for a while.
They recorded Parasite, they recorded Lover All I Can, and actually they just played Los Angeles, and actually a couple of cool bands played Los Angeles recently, and we just couldn't help it. They asked us to play. Got up and did two tunes with Pantera, kicked my ass. We did She and Cold Gin. And we did.
Daryl, I know. I think Daryl might even have a Kiss tattoo.
Daryl's entire front here is Ace's face, right there, tattooed.
They're a huge Kiss fan.
And but even more important is they just kick-ass guys. They really know how to do this stuff the right way. And we jumped up with Anthrax, and a lot of cool bands. Red Cross. Life's good.
Okay. Now after that, you do Christine 16 is done by the Gin Blossoms.
That's right.
And then we've got Rock and Roll All Night by Toad the Wet Sprocket. I mean, two bands that you wouldn't necessarily think as being hard rock bands. Definitely they're not bands that we play on the Headbangers Ball, but sure all these people are very influenced by Kiss.
Dinosaur Jr. Very hip.
The Lemonheads. Those are bands that we wouldn't necessarily think of as being Kiss-type bands, but you chose
you know
to put
what?
These on
when,
the record.
When you look back in retrospect, when I was growing up and I was listening to music, whatever I became in Kiss... Before that is a result of what I was listening to, and I was a Beatle fan. That's all I ever listened to. And whatever happens in that sort of transfusion of musical roots that lead into who you become is a result of that. So Garth listened to Kiss, and then he became Garth. And,
right.
You know, I listened to Beatles, and that's what I became. So that's
what's
happening
here. These
are
just all things. There's a couple other bands I want to mention, ask you some questions about. This record is awesome. You got to get it. I haven't heard it, but
it's
I'm just
called,
looking at it.
It's called...
Kiss My Ass.
Kiss My Ass.
I just like saying that too, because I never get to on Headbangers Ball. Anyways, we're going to talk more about this Kiss My Ass Kiss tribute record as we talk to Gene Simmons. So stay there. We're with Gene Simmons. The record's called Kiss My Ass. I'm going to finish telling you some of the bands that are on it. Mighty Mighty Boss Tones, which I think is like a great party band. Detroit Rock City. I like that band.
The coolest. Dickie sings like he's got pieces of meat flying out of his mouth, which is what it's all about.
Uh-huh. And then there's people that maybe we haven't heard of, like the German version, Die Art
The Arts did.
The Arts
one of the biggest bands in Germany. That's right.
And they do Unholy in German.
In German. And then they break into about 30 seconds of I Was Made for Loving You. Cracks you up. They go, do, and then they start, oh, la, 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 la. Oh, break into that.
Okay, Yoshiki. There's Black Diamond.
Yoshiki is in the biggest group in Japan, a group called X. And we initially were just going to release the X track just for the Japanese market. And the German track is just in the European market, although this collector's item does have this. Anyway, the Yoshiki track is a 7-minute symphony orchestra version of Black Diamond using the American Symphony Orchestra, all 74 pieces of it, recorded here in New York City. And when we heard it, we just were like amazed by it. I mean, it's one thing to come up with a riff. Paul wrote the tune, I wrote the riff. And when you play it on a bass guitar, it's one thing to hear a 74-piece symphony orchestra playing that. It's just beyond.
And when we come back, we're going to find out who this band, Shandy's Addiction, is. You might not have heard of them, but when we tell you who's in it, you will have heard of those guys. But right now, you want the song we're going to play from Kiss?
That's right. Very, very sweet song. Hold on to your balls. Here's the ballad, Unholy.
We're back with Gene Simmons. We are going to find out what Kiss is up to, because I know everybody's saying, okay, let's find out when are we going to see Kiss. But I want you to tell us about this band, Shandy's Addiction, who we might not have ever heard of, the band itself.
Shandy's Addiction is, very quickly, the album took shape very fast. We had over 50 bands that wanted to get involved. We had Ozzy Osbourne and Stone Temple Pilots doing a duet of Watching You. We had Soundgarden doing War Machine, Alice in Chains doing Larger Than Life, just the coolest of the cool. Nine Inch Nails were going to do Love Gun. And of course, the record companies, the Suits, got in the way and told them basically they can't do it. So we had a limited amount of space. So Shandy's Addiction is made up of Maynard from Tool, Tom Morello and the guy, Rage Against the Machine, Faith No More, all together doing Calling Dr. Love. It rips. It'll knock 10 pounds of any fat girl within 1,000 yards of this record. It rips.
One thing I gotta ask you, I mean, all these bands, because I remember when we were talking about it, there were a lot of bands that we had spoke about before that were supposed to be on it. And on the record it says Missing in Action. You see bands that people might expect more to do a Kiss tribute, like Stone Temple Pilots, Ozzy, Soundgarden,
Megadeth,
Skid Row, yeah, Megadeth, Belle Biv DeVoe, Nine Inch Nails, Ministry, Tony. I mean, now, did all these bands actually record?
Some of them did. We had a track of the Melvins with Kurt Cobain right before he passed away doing Going Blind, but it actually came in too late. Dinosaur Jr. beat him to the punch, so...
That mean we might ever have Kiss My Ass too? Yes.
They're talking about it now, but I tell you honestly, without playing games, we're so busy. Next week, we're starting the next studio record. Notice the segue? And then, which we hope that it'll be out by Christmas, then July, August.
Leave them hanging.
That's right, we will.
Let's leave them hanging, because we're going to talk about all the stuff that Kiss is up to, because everybody really wants to know. And there's a lot.
I want to play some Morbid Angel.
Then we'll play Morbid Angel. And we'll do that right now, because Gene wanted, here's Morbid Angel. We have spent most of this evening talking about this Kiss tribute record, Kiss My Ass, but I want to spend some time talking about other stuff right now. First, let's talk about the book.
We have a book.
History.
That's right.
Big coffee table book if you have a strong coffee table.
All you need are the legs, folks. It's 1.25 feet long by 1 foot wide. It weighs in at close to 9 pounds a book. 450 pages of gloss, our history, the stuff that nobody knows about, the pictures, the facts, the names, the places, all of it. Comes in a hard shell case, embossed, which means raised letters, real cool looking stuff, numbered and signed. It's not available.
Signed. Personally signed?
Absolutely.
By
each single copy by the band.
Really?
Yeah, the book is not available in bookstores. We wanted to do something special for, you know, you guys, because you stuck by us for so long. So instead of worrying about going out of bookstores and having to wade through the next guy who wants to read Chaucer or something, but you should read Chaucer, Canterbury Tales. You open up Kiss My Ass, the album, or Kiss My Ass, the video, and inside there's going to be an 800 number. You call if you want, and you reserve your copy, because there's only going to be a certain number. It's a monster. Ba-boom!
9-pound book. We'll talk about recording plans, tour plans, and something that I want to ask, something that I read. But right now we're gonna be playing a video that you actually have a brief part in, and you are not the 2 foot guy with makeup. You're the other Gene Simmons in the video. You seen the video?
I don't know which one you mean.
The Stuttering John.
Check it out. That one.
I'm sure I'd mentioned this to you before, and I was gonna completely stop mentioning it, but I was reading in, I believe, Entertainment Magazine, a little couple questions that it asked about you, and it said something about makeup, and then you said, don't quote me on this, but you said something like, I won't say I won't ever put it on again, we like to keep that door open. Was I mistaken in reading that?
You know, we get asked this question all the time.
I know, and I hate asking the same damn questions. Well, but I read something like this, and then I started saying, well, wait a minute.
I think it's fair to say that the makeup question aside, this Kiss My Ass record is really...
You got to answer this question.
I will.
But you got to answer this question.
I will.
Just say never, or just say, I don't want to answer it. So then we can keep guessing. Because the thing is, I mean, everybody loves a new Kiss, and we thought, yeah, you were never going to do it, and I think you'd even said you'd never do it. But then I'm reading in this article, and it says, we want to keep that door open. What does that mean?
I didn't say we want to keep that door open, but I would never say never. Right now, it doesn't seem attractive because we're just too happy doing what we're doing. But it's also important for everybody to realize that Kiss My Ass is not just a tribute to the present band. We wouldn't be here without Ace and Peter, and that's a very important thing. So this is every bit a tribute to them as it is to us. But putting on the makeup now doesn't appeal to me.
Okay, I just wanted to get that clear. Long form, home video.
It's called Kiss My Ass.
For people that want to see the old stuff, because a lot of the new Kiss fans never got to see the old Kiss live and didn't experience it.
It's going to be the making of Kiss My Ass, the album, but also includes a lot of classic live Kiss clips. In fact, here's a sample of it. Here's Kiss 1975, January in San Francisco. That's a hoot. I remember that show.
So for the people that never got to see old Kiss, long form video,
Kiss My Ass is coming out July, August, and actually includes that kind of stuff as well as a lot of the bands actually in the studio recording their tracks.
We'll talk more about it with Gene Simmons, our guest on Headbangers Ball.
Very cool.
Right on. So that's a rough cut of something that's in the making right now.
Yeah, we're doing it right now. In fact, the numbers you saw on the bottom give us a sense of, like, if I'm talking to the editor and I say, go to TR-346, that tells him immediately, I go, take that scene out. And that's how you communicate. That's
one thing I was noticing when I was watching that home video. You know, some people say that certain things have been done so much and certain things become a cliche. I still love pyrotechnics.
Me too.
I like pyro. I
like
when things explode.
I also think it's fair to say that every band's got to figure out what it is that lifts their skirt. You know, you got to do whatever it is that makes you happy. If lighting your ass on fire is what it is, then you got to do that. Forget about style. Just do whatever it is that touches your heart.
We've been talking about the home video, talking about the Kiss My Ass record. You're going to go in the studio and do new Kiss stuff.
We're starting next week. We've been writing for a year and a half at the same time that we're working on, you know, the upcoming short tour and the history book and editing the long form video and all that. We still have our minds set on this next studio record, which is really going to be a brother record to Revenge, the last studio record.
Which did good.
Very well.
Revenge was a good record.
It
came back. I mean, Unholy was a smoking song. Domino.
Yeah, we did fine. And it's very heartening. We appreciate it when somebody steps up to you and says, you know, that last record is a good record. In fact, even cooler still is to have somebody say, man, I'm a big Kiss fan. I've got every one of your records. And he reels off the last two records.
That's nice.
Cool.
We're going to come back with Kiss, with Gene. We're going to talk about shows. But right now, well, let's play classic Kiss. Here's I Love It Loud.
The subject matter is very hip.
Here with Gene Simmons of Kiss, talking about bands that we like. And when we're going to play a video from a band, very cool band. They'll probably be surprised and stoked to hear that you dig The Offspring.
Crazy.
Great punk rock band, especially, from Orange, California.
Especially self-esteem, that lyric, turn of phrase, very hip. We were just talking about that.
We're going to play them in just a little bit. We've also got Pride and Glory and Helmet, which is another band you're a big fan of.
Love Helmet. I think Paige does amazing things with that guitar. Just anything to make your stomach churn.
Because all these bands, I mean, they must like trip to hear like, whoa, Gene Simmons likes us, you know?
Hey, look, the world is all about new music. Yesterday is always good news and, you know, memory's always good, but it's always new music that makes the world go around. And if you're not in, if you don't know what's happening, if you don't know Helmet and Offspring, yeah.
What here. About live shows for Kiss?
We're going to South America in August, September to play stadiums there. Opening will be Black Sabbath, Slayer, and Suicidal Tendencies.
Who's singing for Black Sabbath on these shows?
I don't know. Do you want to?
There you go.
I don't have a clue. And then we're going back in finishing the record, and then eventually in the new year, a world tour that we hope to put together at least a big stage, at least as big as this.
At least as big with the budget that old Headbanger's Ball has. Can't hit it too hard. Hope it's going to come down. When we come back, we're going to find out what's up with the other guys, especially Paul. Big changes for Paul Stanley.
Big one.
Big changes.
About this
about
big.
As heavy as the new book.
That's right.
About as heavy as history.
About
we'll find out
about this
as
big.
The Headbanger's Ball continues. We're back on the Headbanger's Ball, and the other guys right now, Paul Stanley, tell us what the big news with Paul Stanley is.
This is direct from Los Angeles. A couple of days ago, I was in the hospital. No, I wasn't sick. I was with my pal, my buddy, my brother, Paul Stanley. He just had a baby boy, this big. The next Kiss generation. He just, I mean, he's like...
What was it? I mean, was he like the...
Well, he was, you know, initially...
Because people even got surprised when they found out that Paul Stanley got married.
I want to tell... Well, yeah, he's been married a year. Sweet girl, Pamela. I want to tell you this. I swear to God, this is true. On the night that they took his wife, Pamela, into the hospital to give birth, he and I... and Bob Ezrin were sitting together writing a song. She was due 5-6 o'clock in the afternoon. At 3 o'clock in the afternoon, we're in the middle of writing a new tune. And then finally he just said, you know what? I gotta go. Where are you going? Going to the hospital for the birth of his baby. So on the very same day that his wife was in the hospital, that's Kiss for you.
Right on. Very cool. We're gonna come back. We're gonna talk to Gene and wrap things up. But right now we're gonna play something from Zach Wilde's band, Pride and Glory, and he played on the Headbangers Ball about a month ago, acoustically, and pretty soon everybody's going to know him as not just being the guy that played with Ozzy Osbourne. It's Pride and Glory. Rock. Oh! See, what you don't see behind the scenes is each one of these women give me a hard time, and I love it. Anyways, we're back on the Headbangers Ball with Gene Simmons. Some of the stuff we were talking earlier about Kiss conventions and stuff like that and all the Kiss collectibles, because there is everything. I mean, right now, to get the Kiss dolls is like hundreds of dollars. Kiss lunchbox, killer Kiss pinball machines. I have none of these things, just so you know. I want these things, but I have none of these things. What are some of the most bizarre Kiss collectibles there is? Comic books with real Kiss blood.
That's right. They're weird. Kiss condoms. They're weird.
But are there Kiss condoms?
Oh, yeah. We sell them at concerts. Absolutely. So when you come to a Kiss concert...
You don't even have to say what you were going to say. I can guess. I know what you were going to say. You're going to do another sick play on words. You're probably going to have to edit.
Well,
so I just stopped you before you said it.
I just meant when you come to...
I know. We don't want to have to censor it.
I will tell you
figure it out. You know Gene, kids. Figure out what he's going to say.
I do want to tell you that every once in a while you hear a story about somebody with some, you know, Kiss dolls or whatever that warms the cockles of my heart. You can say cockles.
Cockles are okay.
Cockles are good. Revolting cockles.
Okay.
You can say that. Okay.
That you can say too.
Anyway, when I found out from Trent's girlfriend, Trent Reznor, that when the guy was in the studio, he was about to do Love Gun for the record. Didn't work out. The suit stopped him. But it was a real thrill to find out he's got a recording console, and he's got two dolls on the top of his recording console. A Jesus Christ icon, I guess, with a head going like this, and next to it is a Gene Simmons doll. So. Christ is keeping good company, I guess.
There you go. Now, what would be some of the other strange things that Kiss came out with. I mean, there's like the Kiss toy band.
We had Kiss shoelaces, sneakers. There were Kiss tents. There were Kiss towels. 3D. You know what I love? The GAF 3D ViewMaster things. You know, so see Kiss in concert and you see this 3D thing.
I remember talking to Reed from
Oh, Kiss Maybelline makeup kits.
From Maybelline.
Very hip.
I remember Reed from Corrosion of Conformity saying that when he was a little kid, he went to the Kiss concert and had nightmares ever since. We'll be back talking to Gene Simmons. More Headbangers Ball.
Probably saw my face.
Hey, welcome back to the Headbangers Ball. Listen, nights like tonight, if you miss tonight's show, you don't see me saying this, but you're an idiot. You didn't know what we've got coming up. Let me tell you the stuff we've got coming up on future episodes of Your Headbangers Ball. Coming up next Saturday night, we have got Soundgarden. That is July 2nd. Then July 9th, another legend will be back in the studio. We will have Alice Cooper back in the studio on Headbangers Ball. Gene Simmons, Soundgarden, Alice Cooper, and Chris Cornell from Soundgarden wrote some songs on Alice Cooper. So we'll talk about that and all sorts of other stuff. Real quick, got the record Kiss My Ass, got a long form video, got studio stuff. What else is up? I mean, what?
We are.
If there is anything left. Any big acting parts coming up again?
Nah, I'm acting.
You're a good actor.
I'm
really
acting
are.
Right now. Can you
no,
tell?
But I mean, doing.
The sense, mer-
the
see serious, the way the
like,
eyes.
The bad guy. What movie were you the bad guy in?
A couple of them. Are they, but
start
they
with an M.
Runaway, then I did
that was it.
Wanted Dead or Alive. But they always kill me. Why do they
but
want
But you're a good bad guy.
A good bad. I'd rather be a bad, good.
Good guy.
No, that's not it.
Good bad guys are good.
But we're actually.
Bad guys are bad.
We've actually been so impressed by the fanzines that have come out by the fans. There are thousands of them all over the world, and they always want to know up-to-date stuff. I mean, there's email that you're talking about. So what we're going to be doing soon, if we have the time, is actually putting out our own magazine at least twice a year. It's going to have like 48-page comic book in it, and like at least right now we're planning for over 100 pages of news, behind-the-scenes, memorabilia, all that stuff, and Marvel is going to be putting it out.
Right on.
And it's something we've wanted to do for the longest time, and we want it to be written by you. In other words, the stuff, where are you from, what's your life like, how'd you get into Kiss, what's going on, direct fan-to-fan access on the stand. So if you write an article, boom, the world's going to see it. And we're putting together the team now, and the team, the editors, the writers, the artists, it's going to be you guys, no professionals, nothing. So it's coming soon.
Very cool. Thanks again for stopping
You're welcome.
By.
I had a ball.
Got to keep on coming back, keep us up to date, because you always got something going on. Now, I want to talk about this real quick, about, I'll talk about it after we play the video. This is a video that I never get to put in my say what type of videos we should play on Headbangers Ball. This one comes from a band from Orange County, California. I want to talk about after we play the video. Gene says he digs this band. This band is awesome. I love them. I hope you do too. They're The Offspring, and we're going to talk about them as soon as they're done. This is the last video night.
I like them.
I hope you liked that. That was The Offspring with Come Out and Play. The record's called Smash. They had a record out earlier than that called Ignition's really good. And I want to talk about this stuff really quick, okay? Now, when I was younger, even though I was listening to bands like Kiss, sorry to date you there, Gene.
Oh, I don't care.
But when I was growing up, I was listening to a lot of the music like that. Long time ago in Orange County, if you like that stuff, check out all the older bands like TSOL and The Adolescents and a lot of the old stuff from 1980, which is
Black
great
Flag.
Punk rock, Black Flag.
Bam.
Stuff is coming back now, obviously, with bands like The Offspring and Rancid and Green Day. What did you say? I said Green Day.
Green Day. And find out who they listen to. It's important for you to, you know, be aware of what went on before, because everything is just another page in the book.
Because people are watching, they say, oh, well, Offspring, it doesn't sound like Kiss.
Well, so what?
It's loud and it's good and it's punk rock.
So what?
I think
yeah.
It rules. So that's my opinion for whatever what that's worth. Be here next week when Soundgarden is going to be our guests. And they're great.
That's right.
You like the new Soundgarden record?
Love it.
New
Soundgarden, man.
Right. It's awesome. Thanks again, Gene.
Actually, Black Moon. Ooh.
Good
Black Sun, rather.
We'll talk about it.
Kills.
Good night. I'm Riki Rachtman. Remember to keep one foot in the gutter when fishing the gold. I'll see you next Saturday with Soundgarden. Bye.